Hello Inventors, in this video I'm going to show you how we can create a basketball game using MIT App Inventor. So here we go. Click on New Project. My project name is Basketball Game. So that's our first screen. So first of all, let's close this and click on Layout. And let's just drag and drop the vertical arrangement and just make it width and height is full parent, like this. Now in the left side, you will see the option of drawing an animation. Yes. And just drag and drop that canvas and make it width and height is fill parent. Okay, so that's our playground. Okay, now we can change that playground color, so that will be around something the green. Just try this one. Cool. Now you can see the image split. Just drag and drop this here. I'm gonna add here the basketball hoop. Now I'm gonna add one ball here. You can make that ball radius to the 10, like this, and change that color to something is like band color to the orange. That look fine. Okay, now we need to add some image here, so I'm gonna add the hoop image here. So basketball hoop image, click on image split, and the right side will see here the picture, upload file, choose file. So I already have one image. Okay, this one I have one image. Let's just upload this image and click on okay. Now I'm gonna make that width and height is around 200 pixels. Let's try this. Okay, you can just try in your phone like how this will work. 200 is fine. Okay, but I'm gonna make it more smaller. Okay, so suppose let's try it by 100, and this is also 100. That's good. Okay, so what I need to do here, we need to just use this image like this, and we have one ball. That ball should touch that basketball hoop. Okay, so first of all, we need to move that image sprite. Okay, left, right. Okay, how we can do this? So let's go to the block section. Here, whenever we screen will initialize, okay, or screen will initialize, then we need to call the image split dot speed. You can see, just scroll down and you will see here speed. That's amazing. Now that can move our basketball hoop. Okay, so let's set that speed to the 10, like this. Okay, now once we initialize this, so that will move from left, that will move from here to here like this, but I need to move it from again here. So I need to move it. Okay, after this, touch that edge. So how we can do this? So as you can see here, click on image split, you will see here the image split edge reached. Okay, like this. Then we need to move that image split. You will see the option of move like this, image split move like this, and we can move it to the again XY coordination, XY position. Like just scroll down here, you see the X is 0 and the Y is -5. You can make it Y is also 0. So let's go to the block. Let's click on the XY here and just make them like 5 5 or 0 0. Okay, 0 0. So you can make it 5 5, because once I make it 0 0, so that can be chances to, you know, touch that edge. So again, that will move again 0 0. So that's going to be a loop. So that's why we need to use here the 5 5 value for both. Cool. So if I use the 5 5 value, it means that will be display somewhere between this here. Okay, let's go to the block now. So this will start moving. Now we need to someone click on that button. That button also should move. So you can see the touch touched. Once the people touch that ball, and that ball also going to the speed will be like, click on the ball and you will see here the ball option, set ball speed, this one, and that is around 10, like this. Now we need to set that ball should go up to the straight, like this. Okay, so how we can move it? Because once we start the speed, so that ball move to the this position, like this. So for that, let's go to the block section. Okay, we'll send that ball hiding. Okay, so we can see the ball hiding option, this. That hiding is something like, you can set the direction of that ball. Okay, the hiding is something, so I'm gonna just set it to the 90, so that will move to the top. Okay, that's simple. Now we need to just, once the ball reach to the this edge, we need to move our ball again here. So as you can see here, is the XY position 149 and 268. So you can just make it as like, you know, 200, no, 150 is fine here. And for the Y value, I'm gonna make it the 300. Okay, the downside. Okay, so 150 and 300 I need to set. So for that, simply click on the ball and you will see the move option like this. Okay, now Let's click on the ball first and you'll see the here ball age reached, this one, and call it here simply and click on max. Go here, X and Y position, and X is 150 and Y is 300. Simple. Now, once the ball collide with, okay, so you can see the ball collide with. So once that collide, we have only the one component is image split. So we don't need to use the condition here, okay? So we can directly use that block. If we have the multiple image split, then we can use that other to get the actual component, okay? So we can get that particular component name that ball collide with. So, but we know that we have only one component, so you don't need to worry about that. So once the ball collide with the, image split, so we can have the score option here. So for that, I can have one thing is like, go to the layout like this. So like this one, horizontal arrangement here, like this, and make this with its fill parent like this. Now let's go to the label, just string of one and another one. First label is called the score, okay? Score like this. And make it like 20, make it font bold. Change the background color to none, okay? And make sure the vertical arrangement is also none. And the screen is going to be the same as the canvas. Click on the custom and just copy that color code here from here. Go to the screen and just change that background color. Okay, to go to the custom and just paste it here, like this. Now make sure that should be text is white and make that value for 0 around right now. Font size should be 30 maybe or 20 is fine. And make that text to 0 for now. Click on the label 1 and make that text also the white and make all the thing in a center. Okay, that should be horizontal, should be center, like this, okay. Now we have that, let's make it center also. Now we have that game, okay? So that will increase the score. So go to the block. Once we collide, our ball will collide with the image split. So we'll increase the score, okay? So you can see the plus icon, this one. Now we'll display that score in the label 2. So set label2.text here. And that will, and we need to get the current value. So label2.text here. And just increase it by 1. So just call it here and just call it 1. That's it. Okay. So every time your ball touch the hoop, okay, that one. So that score will, increase. Okay. But we need to just do again one thing. Once that ball touch it, so we need to again move our, ball to the, here in the top. But here one more thing that, we need to stop the speed, okay? Because otherwise, again, that will move again without touching, okay? So hope you can do this. So simply, you can just call that set speed that should be 0, okay? That's 0. And the same thing we need to call on the one that reached also. So now, as you can see here, we have the both code, like ball, this one, speed is the similar code. So you can call it procedure here. Simply, just call it procedure. And move that whole code here like this and just call the procedure instead of that code. Now, as you can see here, the same code we need to call over here. Okay. So just delete that code, and we just need to call here the procedure like this. Okay. So that's the overall game that we have just created. Okay. Let me just try it to run in an emulator. You can see this is our game that hoop is moving. Let's click on that ball to try to that touch that hoop. But yes, touched. You can see the score is 1. Again, you can try and that ball is again come to in the point and it stopped. Okay, and let's try this again. But there's again, yes. Now let's try again. This is touched. That's fantastic. So let's try to change the speed of that ball to 30, suppose. Okay, and ball speed is 0 at the point. Is done. Now let's try it. Oh, zero is good. So you can have the chance to hit it more like this. Okay. So that's the overall game that we have just created. Now there's another point is like how we can make it game over. So just one guy commented, just commented that you can have the limited chance to hit that hoop. Okay. So you can you can add the limited chance for hitting the ball. So that can make your game over, or that can make the finalist for what you have. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please subscribe to our channel, like this video, and share this video. Have a nice day. Be safe. Bye-bye.